Let's try to find the graph of 36 minus x squared using the standard window, negative 10, positive 10 for x, and also y will take negative 10 to positive 10. So we type the function here, 36 minus x squared. Now go to zoom and hit 6 for the standard window. So you don't see exactly nice graph. Now let us change this window to negative 10 to 10, and you have seen that in the graph again. But something missing at the top, so I need y higher value. So go to window and change your y positive here. Maybe we can take it 20 and then see what happens. Graph it again. Not yet. Good. So let me make it 40. Because you can see here, so in the window now, I make y max 40 or 45 will be better. Now graph it. You can see clearly. So this is exactly the equation of a parabola, upside down. And this is called vertex, which is the maximum. So how do you find this maximum? Go to second and then trace. From there, number 4 is your max, hit 4, stay on the left side of that value, which is called left bound, move it to the right side for right bound, hit enter one more time. Now you can see that y is 36, and this value is actually 0 for x. So now if we talk about the domain of this function, this is polynomial function, so domain is entire real line, but we have used restricted domain this one to see the better graph. And the range will be negative infinity to this point, which is 36. So we have got the following. The range is negative infinity to 36 here, and the maximum value is 36, which is attained at x equals 0. So you can say the max point is 0, 36. So we want to graph this function. Since it's a radical function and it has exponent 1/4, so the domain is not the whole real line. So what we need, the inside should be non-negative, which is greater or equal to 0. Now I want to discuss how to solve non-linear inequality. So we write 81 minus x squared equals 0 and solve for x. So you can see that x will be plus or minus 9. So we put a real line here to test which interval I should take as a domain. So you have a negative 9 to positive 9. Take your test points inside, negative 10, positive 10. Now if we plug negative 10 here for x, the answer is negative. If you plug 0, your answer is positive. And if you again plug 10 as a test point on this, still gives me negative. So my domain is actually this one. So the domain we say now, negative 9 to positive 9. So we're going to graph this one in the calculator. I want to type this function in a simple way, like we can use 81 minus x squared, and then your exponent will be 1/4. So I'm using parentheses for my calculator. 1 divided by 4. And we said that our domain is negative 9 to positive 9, so I want to take that domain, go to window, or negative 10, positive 10 is also okay. So let me take standard y, 10 and negative 10, positive 10, and see what happens. So this is the graph. It doesn't look that good. To get your nice graph, you may look at here what happens. If I replace my x by either negative 9 or positive 9, then y will be 0. And if I plug some other values here, so that x is 0, so then y will be 3 actually. 4th root of 81 is 3. So let me put that on here, 3, and see how the graph looks like. Yeah, so you can see a little nice graph. If you want, you can find the maximum point here. This will be 3. And we are done for this one too. We take another function, y equals 3 plus absolute value of 1 minus x. You can look at here that this function is defined for all x values. So the domain will be all real numbers. But range is the question. So let us plot this function first in the calculator. So I write 3 plus, and then I need to take absolute value on 1 minus x. So you can go to math, and from numerics, you can press 1 for absolute, and then type 1 minus x. Close the parenthesis, and go to the standard window first. Go to zoom 6. That will give a standard window. So we are happy. So we can say that, okay, I'm good. So in this case, my smallest value here is, when I replace x by 1, it is 3, you can see. So the smallest value is 3, and the highest will go all the way. So the range will be 3 to infinity. So we can say that the domain of this function, all real numbers, no restriction given, and the range 3 to infinity. And our minimum point here is at x equals 1. So the minimum point is 1 comma 3. Or you can say that the minimum value of the function is 3 attained at x equals 1. So we are taking another function to plot, where y equals x to the 2/3 minus 3x to the negative 1/3. So this exponent is negative, so write it like this. And we can understand clearly, we can take all x values except 0. So our domain will be all real numbers except 0. Now, let's go with the standard window and graph it. So this is plotting your function. So what we understand in this case, that at x equals 0, we have a vertical asymptote. We are given two functions, y equals negative 3x squared plus 6x minus 0.5, and another one is square root of 7 minus 7 over 12 x squared. We want to see if we have any intersection between these two, and then we change something on the second one and see where we find intersection, if we have, how many we have. So let's graph with the standard window. So it's not that good. We can see whether it is touching or crossing. So let us fix a little more. I'm taking chance with window like negative 5 to 5 for x, negative 5 to 5 for y also. And the graph looks like this. It's not clear exactly whether we have intersection. So let's try second trace. 5 is for intersection. So go close to the intersection. This is the first curve, enter. Now it is in the second curve. Let's make sure that it goes to the second curve. Then hit enter. It's calculating and then see what happens. So it is giving me error. That means it doesn't have intersection in this case. So we'll take the second. So now I'm changing, instead of 7, I write 5, and then see if we have intersection. Graph it again. It clearly shows that it has intersection. How do you find it? So you have two intersection points. Second, trace, 5 is intersection. Stay with your first curve. So first we are looking for this side. Enter one more time, then you see intersection. So the first point is coming like 0.67984, and then y value is this. Now we look at the other one. Go to second, trace, 5. Now move your pointer close to the other point. Okay, hit enter. then it goes to the second curve, automatic, hit enter. So you can write down those. This is another point will be 1.3878 and 2.0488, you can say. Okay, we are done for this part.